Hi everyone, Michael Anfield here. Thank you for joining me. So, as you can see from these pictures of bread, for example, so this is a video for new vegans or vegans who are just, well, people that are just plant-based. So, just the food-wise are, eating vegan. But maybe their bread, or maybe some animal ingredients are still in their products that are they're buying. So there are a lot of products that contain animal ingredients. So we've made it simple on a website called thosecrazyvegans.net to actually find ingredients that could be in food or other products. So you just go to vegan section and then from there, animal ingredient list, and you can see the huge list, which includes almost 180 listings, and you can search by a letter. So for example, in bread and things like margarine, they contain whey product. So let's go to W. So whey or whey powder or whey protein is the watery liquid that remains when milk form curds, usually in cakes, cookies, candies, and breads. In cheese making, alternatives there's soybean whey, but you don't really even need whey. There's other ingredients that are included, not just in bread, but other processed foods. That is why it is important if you still decide to buy bread, to buy bread that is vegan. Usually it says vegan on the label. Don't buy it if it says vegetarian or something like that. It still may be vegan, but don't, just be sure. And better because even the vegan breads and other processed foods have not very good ingredients. They don't have wholesome ingredients. Some of them, a lot of them have sugar, added like added processed sugars. They have also a lot of salt and they're made, with a lot of flour. Flour is really not good for us. We need a whole food. And even if it says whole wheat, not necessarily is the whole thing whole wheat, and it's not necessarily healthy. So there are a lot of hidden animal ingredients, as you can see, 177, but there may be even more. So there are a lot of ingredients, and that's why sometimes it is very difficult for people to transition to veganism because there's animal ingredients in everything. Even in our car tires, for God's sakes, there's animal ingredients. Even in a concrete and asphalt, when the construction guys are building and repairing the roads, there's animal ingredients in there. There's animal ingredients even in the office building that you go into, like, or there may be. So it's incredibly difficult to be 100% all the time, and maybe, it's not possible. But that doesn't mean we should not strive to be as vegan as we can, and of course to call ourselves vegan. So there's so many animal ingredients. Let's look at some particular animal ingredients that may be in, baked goods, for example, lactose. So there's all kinds of lanolin in cosmetics and all kinds of things. There's also this L-cysteine coming in baked goods as well, and other products, of course, but this is especially in baked goods. What else is there? Let's see. So many different And even things like maple syrup, we don't even know. Most companies add lard as a foam reducer. Buy organic or check with the company if it's vegan or not. So there's even things that we feel are vegan. And even if the item is not vegan, for example, let's say you do buy a maple syrup or molasses that's fully not vegan. Maybe they use some kind of product that is, or ingredient that is not vegan. So it's unfortunate, but once we know that product is not vegan, find another one that is vegan and find out the company. So what else? There's like lots of things, like even natural sources can mean animal or vegetable source. Most often in health food store industries, especially in the cosmetics area, it means animal sources such as animal elastane, glands, fats, proteins, and oils. So natural sources usually come from animals, actually, which I just learned recently, mostly from animals when it says natural sources. So there's so many things like plastic bags. I didn't know. Many plastics, including shopping bags, contain slip agents, reduce the friction of the material. These are made from animal fats. Plastic manufacturers often use additives of animal origin to improve material properties and/or to aid in processing of raw polymers. Food manufacturers are experimenting with carotene protein found in chicken feathers to produce plastics, adhesives, and non-woven materials. Alternatives: reusable bags made from cotton or other plant. So you see, they say here, and woven materials. So that means that they might even be putting into your shirt that's fully cotton. They might be putting who knows what animal ingredients is going in there, and they don't even need to label it. So that is something that we need to take, just to understand. And understand that the reason there are so many hidden animal ingredients in products, first of all, is because there's a demand. And secondly, because the main forms of animal products, which are animal flesh, meat, milk in a form of like drinkable milk and not animal byproducts, cheese, yogurt, any animal dairy product, butter and all that stuff. And then there's, of course, eggs and egg products. And then there's honey and honey byproducts as well. So anything else that is like included in those categories are the main forms of animal like products, animal foods. And what else that they cannot really use, or things that are like byproducts, like things that are that come from animals, but like, I mean, they use everything basically. So they don't discard, I mean, they do discard a lot of animal body parts, but a lot of it they use. Like they use, I don't know, they use all kinds of body parts, eyes and bones and feathers and you name it. They use feather meal for, to put on our crops, all kinds of stuff. It's, you wouldn't imagine. They use blood, they use everything. And this is the list of animal derived ingredients. So do check this out. If you go to those crazyvegans.net, vegan, and then from there you hit animal ingredient list, you will find it. And this list is based on PETA's animal ingredient list. Also, animal ingredient list A to Z, Veganimizomol A to Z, comprehensive guide to identifying and avoiding animal ingredients of animal origins in everyday products, and other various mobile apps and websites and so forth. So it's up to date quite often, April 18. And we never know, like, this is just a big beginning a list. There might be hundreds of other, animal ingredients that we don't even know. But once we start to recognize the plant ingredients and their names, then we start to realize, like, what is this ingredient? I never heard of this, or I never seen this. And this might be animal ingredient. This might not be. Check out the product. Check it if it's a whole food. Check if it's a vegan from a vegan company. All these things can help you in this in making better food choices. And so when you think and you're buying a product, like, think before, do I really need this product? Is it going to make me healthy? Can I buy it for my family so I can transition them or get them to see that vegan foods are really delicious? So there's a lot of transitional foods that are very good at good in mimicking animal foods, but eventually, of course, we need to get to eating more whole foods, whole plant foods. So that's the key to eating more whole plant foods, especially when it comes to our like a raw, fresh foods, raw and fresh foods right from the ground. Just stuff it in your mouth, all the fruits and all the veggies and all the foods that you can imagine that's possible. I mean, bananas alone, there's over 1,000 varieties around the world. So there's no excuse for animal abuse, and the animals don't need your excuses. So, that's one thing. Just go vegan, everybody, because it's so good. And because I love you and everybody loves you, and we want to live in a peaceful and compassionate world with everyone, with all the animals, all of nature, all of each other. And thank you for joining me here on my YouTube channel. Don't forget, weareinterconnected.com/newsletter, where you can download the free interactive short ebook, The Guru's Guide to Spiritual Enlightenment. And don't forget also to like and share this video if you like it. And subscribe to this YouTube channel because I know you want to. Because there are already about 15,000 people that are, well, subscribers of my YouTube channel, and over about 5 million YouTube views already, and millions of other social media views and pamphlets and leaflets that I've been leafleting over the years, 75,000 leaflets over the last 9 or so years. So check out weareinterconnected.com. Don't forget to get my books, the newest one, Our Path to Freedom, How We Can Live a Freer and More Peaceful Life. Once again, I'm Michael Anfield signing off. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you soon.